Our Milky Way galaxy is one among the millions and billions of galaxies in the universe. Actually, we have no idea how many galaxies there are in the universe, or how big the universe itself is. We are just beginning to explore the unknown realms of the universe for the first time. In fact, in the early 20th century, scientists didn't even know that there are galaxies beyond the Milky Way. With the advancement in technology, astronomers are using more and more sophisticated tools to peek deeper into the infinite abyss of the universe. In our quest for exploring the cosmos, we have come across many remarkable discoveries, but none more puzzling than black holes. These are the most extreme objects imaginable. Scientists have been struggling to understand these mysterious bodies for decades, and one such mammoth object resides at the center of the Milky Way galaxy. This is the image of Sagittarius A, the supermassive black hole at the galactic center of Milky Way. You will be surprised to know that it was not the first black hole to be imaged by our researchers. The first black hole to be ever imaged is located at the center of an elliptical galaxy, Messier 87 or M87. If you observe these two images closely, you will find that both look quite similar, but they vastly differ in size and mass. Sagittarius A is around 4 million times heavier than the Sun, while the black hole of M87 is 4 billion times more massive than the Sun. But still, a black hole is a black hole. The M87 black hole came into our observations first because it is way more massive than the other one. Now let's have a closer look at Sagittarius A. It is now believed that there is a supermassive black hole at the center of each large galaxy. We can categorize black holes into many classes, such as stellar mass black holes, supermassive black holes, and ultramassive black holes. Stellar mass black holes are not more massive than 2 to 10 times the mass of the Sun. By one estimation, there are about 100 million such black holes in our Milky Way galaxy alone. The ultramassive black holes are the true giants of the universe. They are billions of times more massive than the Sun. One such example is TUN 618. It is 66 billion times more massive than the Sun. And the supermassive black holes are usually found at the center of a galaxy like the Milky Way. Sagittarius A is one such example. One thing you may have noticed is its name is always written with an asterisk at the end. The reason is quite amusing. In quantum physics, an asterisk is used to indicate the excited state of an atom. And when the astronomers first discovered this black hole, they were so excited that they decided to always put an asterisk at the end of its name. But its discovery was not a simple task. Astronomers had detected an unusual pattern in the movement of stars at the center of our galaxy. They were first puzzled by this observation because it was not clear to which object these stars were orbiting. As we pointed more and more telescopes to this region, we found that the massive object at the center is a powerful radio source. It emitted no other form of electromagnetic radiation except radio waves, and in fact it was practically invisible to our telescopes. After further observations, it was confirmed that it is a supermassive black hole. This discovery revolutionized our understanding of the formation of large galaxies. After this finding, it was clear that every large galaxy harbored a supermassive black hole at its center. So, is it possible that these supermassive black holes are the reasons for the formation of large galaxies? Much like how our solar system was created around the Sun. Do we owe the formation of the Milky Way galaxy to the black hole, Sagittarius A? It is yet to be answered. We know that we have much to learn about these black holes, and we are steadily moving forward. It is a daunting and an extremely difficult task to get precise data about an object which is sitting at about 26,000 light years away. But still, our pioneers and researchers did manage to gather enough information to continue our quest of understanding these mysterious objects. These black holes may contain the deep secrets of the cosmos we are trying to find. When we get a complete knowledge about these black holes, we may begin to look at the universe from a completely new perspective. And maybe the secret to that knowledge lies no farther than the center of our galaxy.